En 1492, Cristóbal Colón encountered the Taíno people for the first time. He wrote in his journals, saying, "They love their neighbors as themselves, and they have the sweetest talk in the world. They are gentle and always laughing." If that's the case, then that pretty much summarizes my mother, who grew up in El Campo de Vega Baja, on a little house on top of stilts. Her environment that cultivated a love for all the animals that surrounded her, the birds and stars of the heavens, the fish of the ocean, and of course, the voracious and fierce coquí. The soil beneath her feet instilled a love and appreciation for her creator. It affected everything she did and everyone she touched.
Sembrar y nunca podré olvidar que bebí café en jataca, aún recuerdo la hamaca, mucho en ella me mecí, de ella caídas me di, cuando en ella me mecía, arriba en la serranía, boricua como el coquí, arriba en la serranía. Cantarle a mi tierra como el coquí borincano.
Eventually, when my mother was around 15, it came time for her and her siblings to reunite with their mother, mi abuelita, who had come to New York to work and establish a place for them to live. It was like transplanting a wildflower from the field to a new garden filled with concrete. Yes, it was time for her to relocate, but that little girl would eventually grow into an elegant flamboyant with a beauty that would shine and could not go unnoticed. So she left one island and landed on another, just like many a marine tiger in those days. And not only that, her mother was able to situate herself at 102nd Street, Central Park West. You couldn't ask for a better place to live, as a New Yorker. And that's what she would eventually become, a New Yorkina. And when they finally came together, man, they looked good. Their first family portrait looked like gold. mi abuelita, Mama Lucy. My mother's siblings, Negrita, Tata, Papo, and of course, my mother Josefa. My mother was enamored with Central Park, the lakes, the birds, the museums. She loved art. There were many things to love about New York. But the one thing that caught her eye, the one thing that caught her attention, was fashion. She loved clothing. Clothing can add to the beauty you already possess. But with Josefa, it was her inner beauty that made her glow. Only one word comes to mind when you saw her dress up. ¡Huepa!
Lindo eres cuando amaneces y se oye el cantillo del gallo. Lindo eres cuando amaneces y se oye el cantillo del gallo. El sol con sus lindos rayos todo tu suelo embellece. Con su brillantez te ofrece lindos rayos de abanico.
Eventually, my mother moved to the Bronx with her family. Now, the Bronx was a little different than 102nd Street, Central Park West. But one thing was certain, the flavor from where she originated was everywhere. And it all started with the food. Cuchifrito places ruled. Pastelillos, empanadas, pernil, ropa vieja, and of course, my favorite, pasteles y alcapurrias. Vaya!
Inteligente, un jíbaro preparado, y a chinchorro.com él siempre está conectado para ver si en la catumba está el holgorio montado o si mi amigo Rubén ya tiene el lechón asado.
After some time passed, Josefa met my father at the Hunts Point Palace in the Bronx. He instantly knew she was the one. Bone of my bone, flesh of my flesh, was his immediate reaction. They fell in love, and that love continues to this day. Josefa loved children, and they loved her. So naturally, it wasn't long before I came along. Everyone in my family had nicknames. My uncle called me Pork Chop, or Chuleta. I never understood why. My mother and father took me everywhere. I had a wonderful childhood. During my childhood, we lived in the South Bronx. What always fascinated me was how people from the old country always try to recreate a piece of their native soil. The Bronx was littered with casitas that looked like little pieces of el campo with chickens and all. One of the many things that she did that brought so much joy to me and my father was what she did to our apartment. She had such a green thumb. Everything she touched grew. Our living room looked like a yunque. I was always around greenery as I grew up. It nurtured a love of creation that's still with me today. The love my mother had for nature was only superseded by the love she had for her Heavenly Father. She was such a spiritual woman. And leave it to her. She got baptized at Orchard Beach in 1958, and it turns out that that was the largest mass baptism the Bronx had ever seen. Over 7,000 people got baptized on that one day. Even the convention she attended was marked as the largest crowd Yankee Stadium had ever seen. Oye, ella fue un caso, for real. Josefa loved life. She had a faith that just kept her happy all the time. A friend of mine once said, "Your mother always tries to make you laugh. When you were at your lowest, she found a way to make you smile." You know, she did so because it was just who she was. Was she perfect? Absolutely not. She could read you before you published. If there was a crosshair between you and her, she'd let you know in a blink. Like they say, no tenía pelo en la lengua. But one thing is certain. She gave love and expected love unconditionally. You know, the world may not have known her, but those of us who did, who truly did know her, we thought the world of her. In our eyes, she's a beautiful flamboyant, a flamboyant that we will soon see. She looked forward to the day when the entire earth would look like her native soil. Her faith was unshakable. And me and my father, we look forward to seeing her in that new world. Bright, strong, healthy, dancing all the time. Well, in a nutshell, that's a little bit of Josefa. Until then, oye, nos vemos. Te veo mañana friando papa. peace out, people.
I got a
huepa.
Coqui serenito de la madrugada. Coqui, ya salió un rayito, vete a descansar. Coqui, ya has amanecido con tu bello cantar. Aguarda hasta la noche y vuélveme a cantar. Tu vida, mi amigo, es digna de admirar. Coqui, cuando estoy dormido, tu lema es cantar. Coqui, por eso te admiro, pues me hiciste inspirar. Y mientras tú descanses, yo te voy a cantar lindas melodías que mi corazón te brinda, porque no hay cosa más linda que tú. Yes.